Hello friends, welcome back to the Design Patterns video series. In this video, I am going to discuss the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in C# with examples. Please watch our previous video where we discussed the Builder Design Pattern real-time example. The Fluent Interface Design Pattern falls under the category of Creational Design Pattern. As part of this video, we are going to discuss the following pointers. First, we will discuss what is Fluent Interface Design Pattern. Then we will understand the concept of method chaining in C#. Then we will implement the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in C# with one example. And finally, we will discuss when to use the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in real-time applications. Right? The point that you need to remember before proceeding is that the Fluent Interface and method chaining are related to each other. Or we can say that one is a concept and the other one is its implementation. Here, Fluent Interface is the concept and method chaining is its implementation. Here in this video, first we will discuss the Fluent Interface concept and then we will move towards method chaining, that is its implementation. So what is Fluent Interface Design Pattern? According to Wikipedia, in software engineering, the Fluent Interface is an object-oriented API whose design depends extensively on method chaining. Its goal is to increase code readability by creating a domain-specific language. So when working with applications, you might often find that the source code has become so complex that it is very difficult to understand and maintain. Fluent Interface and method chaining are two concepts that attempt to make your code readable and simple. In simple words, we can say that the main objective of Fluent Interface Design Pattern is that we can apply multiple methods to an object by connecting them with dots without having to re-specify the object name each time. If this is not clear at the moment, then don't worry, we'll understand this with an example. Let us understand how to implement the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in C# with example. Let us say we have the following employee class. As you can see, the employee class is having four properties, that is full name, date of birth, department and address. Now, if we want to consume the employee object, then we generally create an instance of the employee class and set the respective properties of the employee object something as follows, right? We'll create an employee object and then using the dot operator, we'll specify the property name and we'll set the values, right? The Fluent Interface Design Pattern simplifies our object consumption code by making our code more simple, readable and understandable. Isn't it nice to set the object properties as follows? If you create such kind of interfaces, then it is like speaking a sentence that would really make the class consumption code more simple and more readable. Now the next thing is how to achieve this. To achieve this, we have something called method chaining. So the point that you need to remember is Fluent Interface is the concept and method chaining is its implementation. So now let us understand what is method chaining. Method chaining is a common technique where each method returns an object and all these methods can be chained together to form a single statement. Let us see how to implement method chaining in C#. In order to achieve this, first we need to create a wrapper around the employee class something as follows. Here, Fluent Employee is the name of the wrapper. As you can see, here we have created methods for each property of the employee class. Also notice that the return type of each method is set to Fluent Employee. Now, this Fluent Employee interface is going to be consumed by the client. So with the above Fluent Employee class, now the client code should look as follows, right? Now you can see here we created an instance of a Fluent Employee class and then call the methods of a Fluent Employee class one after another by using the dot operator. And each of these method is going to set the property values of the employee object internally. That is, the name of the employee method sets the full name property value, the born method sets the date of birth property value, the working method sets the department property, and the stay at method sets the address property of the employee object, right? So let us open Visual Studio and implement this example. So far what I have done is I have created one console application with the name Fluent Interface Demo. Then I have added one class file with the name employee.cs, right? And in this class file, I have added the four properties, right? Full name, date of birth, department, and address. Then I have created another class file with the name fluentemployee.cs. This Fluent Employee class is actually a wrapper for the employee class. This class is having four methods, that is name of the employee, born, working on, and stay at, right? The name of the employee method accepts the full name as a parameter, and it will set the full name property of the employee object, right? Similarly, the born method accepts date of birth as input parameter, then it will set the date of birth of property of the employee object. Similarly, working on method accepts department as the input parameter, and it will set the department property of the employee object. And finally, the stays at method accepts the address parameter, and it will set the address property of the employee object. Further, if you notice, the return type of all these methods is Fluent Employee, and this is the reason why we can call all these methods one after another using the dot operator. Now let us see how to call these methods using method chaining, or you can say calling all these methods using the dot operator. Let us go to the program class, which is going to be our client, right? Here, as you can see, first we create an object of the Fluent Employee class, and then calling all the methods of the Fluent Employee class one after another by using the dot operator, right? This is how we can implement the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in C#. Now the question is, when do we need to use the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in C#? We need to use the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in the following scenarios. During unit testing, when the developers are not full-fledged programmers, when you want your code to be readable by non-programmers so that they can understand if the code is satisfied with their business requirement or not. If you are a component seller and you want to stand out in the market as compared to the others by making your interface similar. I have seen the Fluent Interface Design Pattern is extensively used in LeanQ queries like searching, sorting, pagination, grouping, etc. Let us understand this. Suppose we have the following dictionary, right? This translation dictionary contains the data in the form of string key value pair, that is, both the key and values are string type. Now we need to find the translations for English words containing the letter A, sorted by length and display in uppercase. Then using LeanQ extension method and method chaining, we can achieve this very easily as follows. Here you can see we are calling the where, order by, and select methods one after another using dot operator. This is nothing but method chaining. This is possible because where, order by, and select methods are implemented as extension methods on IEnumerable, and all these methods return an object of IEnumerable type, right? What next? In the next video, I am going to discuss prototype design pattern in C# with examples. Here in this video, I try to explain the Fluent Interface Design Pattern in C# with examples. I hope you enjoy this video. In case you need the code and text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. Thank you for watching this video.